So I'm at a place where there's a large collection of airplanes. In this particular spot where the collection is on the wall, the collection focuses on World War II. And this is the Junkers, the German Junkers. Now notice on the tail the swastika. The swastika is an ancient occult symbol.
Yeah, I like worms.
And the Nazis kind of reversed the one of the sides on it, the sides. But basically the swastika is four sevens. Four sevens. And remember, seven is the Zion, or the mind weapon. So if you have four of them, there's no hope for your mind. You're taken in. So you're taken in by World War II hoaxing. That these things flew around, dropped bombs on people, and killed people. Truth of the matter, didn't happen. So the British also had a plane that was supposed to have saved England, and that would be the Spitfire. Supermarine Spitfire. This is a little different version, I guess, called the Supermarine. Notice the symbolism, the blue and the red. Now that's kind of the two poles in the hoax lie system, the blue and the red. And then the blue and the red together makes purple, which is the completion. And it looks like there's a little shade of purple there on the wings. But it's just another way of saying using the occult against you. They're all different forms, colors, words, numbers, symbols, you name it. It's just a way of creating spells. So now we're going to go to the Messerschmitt, which was supposed to be the fighting machine up in the air. Shoot down anything because it was fast, and you had kind of a dual war supposedly between the Messerschmitt and the Spitfire. And the Messerschmitt looked pretty good, at least in terms of the statistics, but Spitfire seemed to be just a little bit better. I hope I'm understanding this correctly, but here's the deal: none of it happened. I know you've seen a lot of movies, and I know you've read a lot, and I know that you believe it, but none of it happened at all. So here's some more German World War II hoaxes. Now I'm not saying these weren't real, actual planes that were built. They were. And I'm not saying they didn't go up in the air, they did. It's just that there was never actual air-to-air combat killing one another. This is the Heinkel. Some of you may know a lot more about these planes than I do, but I'm just going to focus again on the symbols. Notice the swastika. And once again, back to the British. The Hawker Hurricane. I have to try to go through the reflection of the light isn't too great for you to see. Anyhow, so supposedly up above everybody, there's an aerial combat war going on. Bombs are being dropped everywhere. Bombs on London didn't happen. aerial combat, Spitfires, having it out with Messerschmitts. You name it. Go ahead, fantasize. That's all it is. It's war fantasy. War fantasy. But let's not forget who is in charge of the Luftwaffe. Hermann Göring. You know who Hermann Göring was? Did you ever wonder why they permitted in the Luftwaffe such a huge man? I mean huge in physical size and stature. I mean huge in belly. Did you ever wonder why? I'm going to tell you why. Because that huge man, Hermann Göring, was actually none other than Orson Welles. Orson Welles, that's right, was Hermann Göring. It was all play. And as boys grew up in a certain age, they were taught to play war. I was. It's one of my favorite games to play. War. We got soldiers, toy soldiers, plastic toy soldiers, set them up, had little tanks around them. Then we'd have pretend battles. And in one particular battle, we actually threw stones and knocked down the other soldiers. And guess what? One of the stones hit my head. Now you know what happened to me. I got hit with a stone in the head playing war. But guess what? I don't play war anymore. Excuse me. It wasn't, you know what, sneeze with all kinds of contagions. So now you know what happened to me. A stone hit my head as a little boy. But I don't play war anymore. War is a game. And it's executed quite well. And it's quite convincing. But what you have to do is examine the footage. Examine the words. And take the mask off. I took it off of Hermann Göring. Guess who I found? Orson Welles. So I'd like to thank you for watching this video. Reporting to you live from a propaganda poster nightmare. Thank you. End of video.